It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, you have a service running on Compute Engine virtual machine instances behind a global load balancer. You need to ensure that when the instance fails, it is recovered. What should you do? The key parts of this question are that you've got these virtual machine instances, it is sitting behind a global load balancer, and as with all other instances, it possibly could fail. But when that happens, we don't want to lose capacity for a long time. We want to recover it soon so that we can bring back the available capacity. What are our options now? Option A suggests that we set up health checks in the load balancer configuration. Is that possible? The answer is very much yes. When you create a new load balancer, as in step one, you can also configure a backend service in step two. As shown in step three, we can also associate a health check with it to say, let's keep polling this backend or to figure out if it is healthy or not, based on certain intervals and timeouts and thresholds. However, health checks via the load balancers identify VMs that can accept traffic against those that cannot accept traffic. It does not necessarily bring back the machine. So the load balancer is only routing requests to machines that can accept them, as opposed to ones that cannot. And it does not necessarily know whether it's down or it needs to be restarted. It just knows that it is inaccessible or unhealthy. So even though this is somewhat what we want, it does not necessarily complete the solution that we require. So I'm leaning towards a no on this particular option, but you know, with a lot of these questions, what we tend to do is, if it kind of solves a problem, we need to look for something that is better than what is currently available. So if there's nothing better than this, maybe we'll have to come back to this. But for now, I'm leaning towards a no on this, but I leave it as questionable and maybe we'll come back later. Option B suggests that you deploy a service to the instances to notify you when they fail. That does not make logical sense. How is a machine that is already down, that has already failed, going to notify you? So just using common sense, B is not an option at all. Option C suggests that you use stack driver alerting to trigger a workflow to reboot the instance. What are the kind of stack driver alerting that is possible? We have multiple notification channels. An email can be sent, we can see it on console, we can supply it to certain external utilities or services like PagerDuty, or even add webhooks or notification Slack, or send SMS, and even PubSub is possible. So there's different ways in which these alerts can reach you. We could potentially employ, say, some of the other services, or even PubSub to create a workflow that will somehow restart that machine. When we receive the PubSub request, maybe we send it to another service that figures out that the new machine needs to be brought back up and then do that. But this involves a lot of manual work and therefore is just overly complex and convoluted. Just on that factor, I'm very much willing to let this option go. Option D suggests that we set up health checks in the managed instance group. Let's see how that is done. When you create a managed instance group based on a template, we can also set in a policy as shown in step 3 here that we want to automatically restart the machine in case of a hardware failure. If that be the case, then the machine can be automatically brought back up. Not only in that case, but it is also possible to add a health check apart from the auto healing that we already saw. So you can configure a health check to figure out when you want this machine to be restarted. Given all of that, option D therefore becomes the best option, which is to set up health checks in the managed instance group configuration, because that actually solves the problem of bringing back or recovering a failed instance. All right, now it's time for you to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead, do that right now, because there's loads of great content coming up for learning Google Cloud and preparing for the certifications.